Alright, so we're gonna head up the hill, up the trail, and see if we can fix the flat on this tractor. So I'll check back in with you in a minute. Okay, so we up here, and I'm about to head to the tractor, get this thing up off the ground with the outriggers, and see if I can replace this stem. So let me, you can see the tractor there. So I had to buy a bunch of stuff yesterday, but the primary tool that I wanted was something to install the stem. I couldn't really find a stem installer except online, and that I would get it by Friday, but I wanted to come up here this morning. So the other primary tool was a portable 20 volt pump, which I have now. So I'm gonna see if I can get this thing off the ground. Quick kick some of those branches and stuff out the way, and then get in there and repair this tire. Let's see how this goes. Put this camera down and get to work. So it's real cluttered back there. I'm gonna see if I can find a stable place to put the camera so you can see what I'm doing. In here, but today I did put on my snake gaiters, so try to be at least a little bit more careful. I don't know where I'm gonna stick this camera. It's gonna get you a clean shot. Right, so put some tools up here to take care of business today. Gloves. I got a stem here. This is the stem that came off the tire. It doesn't appear to be damaged or cracked, but we'll know once we got something in there. What some lube, some grease, multi-purpose synthetic grease. Now this is a core installer and remover, but I'm just probably going to be using it to see if necessary to push the stem back in. I've got a pair of needle nose pliers. My goal will be to try to squeeze the bottom of this stem and see if I can get it in the hole. If not, then I'm going to try to push with this here flathead screwdriver. And of course, the main tool, the pump. All right, so let's get this. Oh boy, that's where it is, I guess. And snake gaiters, because I'm stepping in a whole lot of debris right here. Let's see what we can do. Grease up this hole, this stem. Should have bought a little chair. Got it. It's in there. Now, inshallah, we can pump up this tire. Gonna get loud, y'all. Let's see what happens. Now, it says 20 PSI. Let's see what we can do. It may take a while. Now I've got somewhere around close to 10 PSI inside the tire.
definitely taken back its form, and it's hard to the touch. Now, these tires had liquid ballast in it. Basically, all that does is shift the weight back towards the middle of the tractor when you have a heavy load on your front loader. Now, I can replace the liquid that was in here with windshield washing fluid, and that will work just fine because it's not going to freeze down to at least minus 25 degrees. From the videos that I watched, they say it'll probably take about 12 bottles to get it to where the fluid is approximately around this much in the tire, and the rest of the way I will fill it with air. But because I'm out here in the field and not in some comfy garage somewhere, basically all I'm doing is putting air in it. I didn't bring a jack. You don't need one if you have the outriggers for the backhoe, so that's what I did. It's getting about 20 psi. Tire feels very hard. I'm gonna get it to 20 psi, and then I'm gonna see if I can take these bad boys back down the hill. And this is all I'm doing today. I'm not cutting down any trees today. I didn't come out here to do any work. I left my tools inside the blind. So tomorrow it's supposed to rain. If it's not raining in the morning, I'll come up here, cut down some trees, and push some stuff. So back to the fact that a ballast in the tires, the water weight from the glass cleaner, gives extra weight to the tires. That's going to improve your traction. But I have a lot of weight in the fact that I'm using the backhoe, so I'm not in a rush to add back the water. I'll do that at another time. Plus, I have to buy all of the glass cleaner. I'm going to buy about 20, maybe 20 bottles just in case, so I have some overlap. That's 20 psi. Man, that thing was loud because I'm still screaming. So I'm about 20 psi. I don't hear any leaking. So that confirms my wish that the stem was not broken in any way. So the tool that actually gave me the success this morning, alhamdulillah, I used the needle nose pliers to squeeze the back of the stem and get the initial piece inside. And after some struggle with the screwdriver and this as well, I ended up using the stem core removal and installation tool to basically just push down fairly hard against the back of the stem, and that just pushed it right in there. So this is definitely a great tool. I got it from AutoZone. You can get a whole kit on Amazon that would have made this job 100 times easier and quicker. But alhamdulillah, the job is done. That's what you do on the home.